Thank you so much for coming out. I'm glad we've managed to do this in the end. My name is Milo Yiannopoulos. I'm here to give you a warning. I'm here to give you a warning from Europe. I'm from London, and I know what happens when governments and the media collude to pander to and to mollycoddle Islam. I know what happens to gay people. I know what happens to trans people. I know what happens to women. I know what happens to all the minorities that the left claims that it is here to defend. I'll give you a few statistics from the UK. My team's put together some numbers that I want to share with you because I want you to understand where America could be going. Gallup poll of Muslims in the UK found that not a single one of 1,001 Muslims who were polled, not a single one thought that homosexuality was acceptable.
That's right.
100% of British Muslims believed that homosexuality was unacceptable. This is not radical Islam, the phrase that your president has finally been forced to say. Woo! This is not terrorism. This is not any of the things that you see on your television connected with ISIS. This is not the crazy people blowing themselves up or even the guys throwing gay people like me off the roof in Raqqa, in Iran, on cranes, whatever. This is Muslims in the West. 100% of British Muslims believe that homosexuality is unacceptable. Another poll recently showed that 39% of British Muslims believe that a woman should always obey her husband. 25% of them believe that Sharia law should be enacted in the UK, which treats women's testimony in some cases as worth half or less than that of a man's. This is not radical Islam. This is Islam.
Woo! Yes.
And I want you to take away with you something that we are learning painfully in Europe now. And that is the politicians do not have your back. Yeah. The media does not have your back. People are not going to protect gays or women or blacks or Latinos or any other minority. You've got to do it for yourself. When I said this, you'd say fire back. As they say on the internet, armed gays don't get bashed. And when your celebrities that you listen to, and the media that you listen to, when your politicians are saying the answer to this is fewer guns, that horrifies me. Gun-free zones are the most dangerous places in America. Because gun-free zones provide safe spaces for killers. The left likes to talk about safe spaces. While safe spaces for murderers are gun-free zones. And most of the most deadly and most of the big headline-grabbing tragedies and attacks in America recently have happened where? In gun-free zones.
Yep.
Because killers and crazies don't look at a sign on the wall that says no guns here and say, oh, okay, all right, I'll go home. They walk in there safe in the knowledge that nobody is gonna fight back. See, the progressive left, the social justice warrior left in America, is the single biggest enemy to gay people, to gay security, and to the well-being of homosexuals and every other minority they claim to represent that exists in America today.
Tell them.
Woo! Woo! Some more statistics from England, where I'm from. 52%, 100% of the Muslims in the Gallup poll believe that homosexuality was unacceptable. In a second poll, 52% believe that it should be made illegal. So my sex life, my love life, should be against the law. Well, the data is going to be supplemented with murder. The data is going to be supplemented with more events like you've just had here in Orlando. 50 people, 49, 50 people, and another 50 maimed. This is 100 people whose lives were irrevocably, irredeemably changed by one lunatic whose philosophy was informed by not just radical Islam, but Islam as it is practiced today in all parts of the world. Muslims pouring into Europe and the UK, we see it happening where I come from, and I don't want that to happen to America. America is the greatest country in the world. There is a reason I'm here, because I love this country, and I love the principles on which this country was founded. Freedom of speech, freedom of thought, freedom of movement, democracy, capitalism, property rights, all of these things have given minorities rights unprecedented anywhere else in the world. The American left, the progressive left, the social justice left hates women, gays, and minorities. It is a band of spoiled brat white liberals who care for nothing except their own self-esteem. They don't care about anything except feeling good about themselves and advertising their own moral virtue to everybody else. And while they are doing it, they are denying the rights of minorities to protect themselves. They are denying the rights of minorities to be informed about the risks that are out there. And importing Muslims into this country is going to represent significant risk to minorities. Politicians don't want you to hear that. You hear that from people, it sounds like, oh, crazy right-wing rhetoric. This is the reality that Europe is living through. Please don't make our mistakes. America is better than that, and you have an opportunity now to save yourselves before this happens. My team drove past a number of mosques in the center of Orlando yesterday to discover them crawling with police officers, because woe betide anybody should be rude about Muslims. That would be a hate crime. Let's make sure that we arrest everybody who's causing trouble outside of mosques after, you know, what just happened. But what they couldn't do is spare 6 or 8 officers to let a gay man say what the media won't tell you, say what politicians won't say what your celebrities are too fucking dumb to realize. Which is that this is not radical Islam, it is not terrorists. Forcing Obama to say radical Islam is only 25% of the war. The rest, thank God the sun's gone. Thanks for waiting so long, by the way. The rest of the battle is being honest about the challenges that you face in this country. After the Second World War, when Jews saw what had happened to them in the Holocaust, and they saw the number of other Jews who had said nothing, who had done nothing, when that particular minority was targeted by a different ugly ideology. After the Second World War, they said never again. The creation of the State of Israel, whatever your political views, however you feel about Palestine versus Israel, the pugnaciousness, the determination, and the effectiveness of the IDF, of the Israeli military forces, the fact that it is one of the most effective and brilliant armies in the world, one of the most efficient fighting forces in the world, is the result of what happened in the Second World War. My hope after today, after the ugly and disgusting thing that happened here, is that gay people say too, like the Jews did after the Second World War, never again, and gay people too, let Islamic fundamentalist preachers and Muslims everywhere who are tempted into thinking that they can treat gay people like this, they can treat women like this, they can treat Latinos like this, they can treat blacks like this, they can treat anyone like this, that we will shoot back. Yeah. And to those liberals who say the answer is gun-free zones, those liberals who say, oh, can't we all just love each other? Your entreaties to peace, love, and understanding on Twitter are not changing the views of people in mosques around this city, are not changing the views of people in mosques anywhere else in this country. They are not changing the views of ISIS. They are not changing the views of the immigrants who come into Europe. They are changing nothing. They're not helping you. They're not serving you. They're doing nothing for you. They are instead lulling you into a false sense of security that you are safe. You are not safe. The best thing you can do in America, because you are in the best country in the world, as I said, and you have two things on your side that Europe doesn't. You have the First Amendment, which means, or at least should mean, that people like me, who don't even belong here in a way, you know, I'm not a citizen here, can come here and say how whatever they feel. Most of this talk would have got me arrested in Europe. Can come here and say whatever they want, and you guys can say whatever you want. And that First Amendment is underpinned by the Second. It is your right to bear arms, it is your right to protect yourself. If 2, 3, 4 people had been armed in that nightclub, it would have ended very differently. Gay people need an end to gun-free zones. Gay people need an end to the pointless pacifism of the left, because we have a threat on our shores, in our communities, in our societies, in streets not far from here, that requires a response from the minorities the left has given up on. It refuses to protect us. Instead, it pits us against each other. It creates a victimhood hierarchy with Muslims at the top. Well, the problem with putting Muslims at the top is they want to kill everyone else on the list. Gavin McInnes from the Anti-Cumia Network.
Isn't it funny how a Canadian immigrant and a British tourist are telling Americans how great their country is? It was founded by guys who wrote down on a piece of paper the basics. And they knew the pendulum would swing back and forth, so they added amendments. And the First Amendment said free speech. We have a gay man here who would like to discuss the slaughter of at least 49 gay individuals. He's prevented from that. He says, I would like to talk about the prevention. That's prevented. And we're told, oh, well, they can't provide security. That is total and utter bullshit. We have security right now surrounding us. We have cops on the roofs. That is a lie. What is really going on here is we are consumed with Islamophobia, and the Islamophobia we're consumed with is Islamophobia phobia. We would rather die, we would literally rather die than offend. We would rather die than stray from the narrative. Right now, we have a culture in our country that doesn't like us, that wants to replace us. But our obsession with intolerance includes the intolerant. Our obsession with multiculturalism includes a monoculture that wants to replace us. The liberal left narrative has said, the enemy of my enemy is my friend. And they have chosen the Islamic radical right, whatever you want to call them. They're just really devout Muslims at the end of the day. They've chosen them as their bedfellows. And we keep sitting here screaming, they're going to kill you first. Hey, gays, we're the only guys that like you. Now, I'm a conservative. I'm pretty uptight. I'm not bananas about gays. I think when I start to think
like
about
all, actually.
What they, when I start to think about what they actually do, it makes me go. But we have a 2.0 in our religion. We've updated it. So I want us all to recognize that the West is the best.
Yeah.
And America is the greatest.
Woo! Yeah.
And yeah, homosexuality is a little weird. We're the most advanced. And as a straight man, standing here with a gay man, I would just like to say, fuck you, Islam.
There's a lot of reports that the gunman might have been a homosexual. And he probably was. But there's a difference between self-loathing Christians who just sit at home and get angry and self-loathing Muslims who go out and murder people. And the difference is the ideology, the difference is the religion. I cannot stress this enough. What the left is going to tell you is that conflating Islam with Islamism is hateful. It is, you know, it is right-wing rhetoric. It is, you know, it is not something that civilized people do, and it betrays the, you know, what we all know about our Muslim friends and all the rest of it. I just ruminate on the reality of being a gay person in the Muslim world. 100 million people live in countries where you can be put to death for being gay. 100 million. We don't have that in the West. Why? Because we have democratic capitalism, and also because we have Christianity. You want to talk to me about Christianity hating homosexuals? The best example, probably the Catholic Church. What was the Catholic Church doing in the 50s and the 60s when being a homosexual was illegal in Ireland, was illegal in the whole UK? It was taking gays in, making them part of the clergy, giving them a home, giving them sanctuary. Like, you know, fine, the Catholic Church didn't agree with what they did, so it asked them not to practice that while they were part of the church's family. But the Catholic Church has been looking after gay people since long before any Western state did. There is nothing. There is nothing remotely comparable in the Islamic world. Nothing whatsoever. And this guy's ideology, the hate preacher, in, you know, north of Orlando, 45 minutes drive from here, there's a mosque which hosted a guy who said that for compassionate reasons, the compassionate thing to do was to kill all gays. 45 minutes drive from here, and the guy who said that was hosted 3 weeks ago. We don't have that in Christianity. And idiots like Sally Cohn, this Jewish lesbian feminist lunatic that you'll see on CNN, possibly the dumbest woman in America, and she's up against some stiff competition with Rachel Maddow and Nancy Pelosi, and I'm showing my hand, says that her conservative Christians treat her worse than her moderate Muslim friends. Well, I'm sorry, but there is no competition between declining to bake a cake and taking to a nightclub and killing or hurting 100 people. It is offensive, it is ridiculous. And I don't use the word offensive very often, but that is. Do not listen to these idiots. When you look as a scientist, as a student, when you look at data, you try to work out what is different about this picture versus this picture. What are the points of contact? What is the same and what is different? And what we find is in these crimes where people are are butchered like this, there is one point of difference, and that difference is Islam. And it is not an Islamism problem, it is a Muslim problem. And America is going to get that problem if it doesn't wake up.
Thank you.
Yeah,
you comment again on Sheikh Sakalishvar's comment about the killing of gays 3 months ago at the Husseini Islamic Center and the lack of comment from Imam Muhammad Musri of the Islamic Society of Central Florida, who's been a spokesperson here for the last 2 days for Islam.
If you go onto the websites of any of the mosques in Orlando, you'll see mealy-mouthed, woolly phrases like, oh, we utterly condemn the acts recently, you know, we had nothing to do with it, washing their hands. Well, their hands cannot be washed. This is not a time for out damn spot. This is a time for we fucked up and we're sorry. They hosted these guys. They hosted guys whose congregations, or whatever they call it, their flocks, listened to hate preachers who said the compassionate thing to do was to murder homosexuals. How dare that mosque in Sanford, north of Orlando, how dare it have a statement on its website in red text, which you can't miss today, saying we utterly disavow, we're, you know, this has nothing to do with us, Islam is a peaceable religion, you know, we feel terrible for the victims. You did this. You hosted this man. This man spread the ideas that this broken, damaged, evil young man grew up on, was bred into, and eventually acted on. And for Islamic leaders to finally, after how many terrorist attacks in the West, finally for them to come out and say, yeah, well, yeah, it's really bad, they shouldn't do it. Like, yeah, no, that's awful, we totally disavow it. You know, there's no worldwide Muslim peace movement. It's taken them decades of terrorist attacks to finally have the balls to come out and say, we disavow this. And what are they doing now? Mealy-mouthed apologies on safe liberal media, rather than saying, we did this, this guy was here, we're gonna make amends, we're gonna make this right. Instead, the comment from the guy that runs this horrible mosque up north, oh, we had no idea he said that. They're liars, and they did this. And at some point, they're gonna have to be held accountable, either to God or to somebody else, because they did this. Well, at least one of the presidential candidates has suggested things that a lot of people find too much, which is a ban on Muslim immigration into the country. People are going to have different views about that. Personally, as a gay person, I'm all in favor. After Orlando, I'm all in favor. If there's something you could do to protect gay people in this country, it's very simple. Close the border. But failing that, gay people need to stop listening to the left. Stop listening to people who say that peace, love, understanding, and pacifism is going to save you. It didn't save those people in the nightclub. It wouldn't save me if somebody came for me in a nightclub. What would save me is getting a residency here and getting a concealed carry pass. I have seen, for instance, I have a store where I sell t-shirts to some of the kids on my college tours. That store has received over 100 threats today. Some of them in Arabic and some of them in English. Many of them from America, some of them from Saudi, some of them from elsewhere. Over 100 threats just to my store. The stuff I get, I can't even read through. It's just too huge. I don't take it tremendously seriously because, unlike the left, I don't like to use threats as currency. I don't use death threats and rape threats and all this kind of stuff as social currency. I prefer to stand on my beliefs and my opinions and the content of my talks. And I don't treat stuff terrifically seriously until recently, in which case, you know, I have to get guys like this because the police won't look after me. But the threats that I've had from, you know, my staff are freaked the fuck out. They are terrified. My staff are emailing me saying, can we do something? Can you make this stop? Can you stop this coming in? Can you stop this happening? Because we've had over 100 people just today from a variety of English and Arabic accounts threatening, you know, my staff, threatening, you know, to bomb the warehouses where my t-shirts are made, you know, all kinds of things like that. I think that in just the same way that Twitter, whose largest investor is a Saudi, has become to some degree Sharia compliant in the last 6 months, I think the American universities are becoming Sharia compliant too. There is one minority on campus that is completely untouchable, is beyond reproach. There is one minority on campus that if you say anything remotely critical about, you are in trouble. Your education's in trouble, your ability to graduate is in trouble. That's Muslims. You want to see a minority on campus? I'm sorry to say it, as ridiculous as it sounds, but this is true. I've done, you know, half my college tour already. I've probably been on more American college campuses this year than anybody else. You want to see a group of people who can't say what they think on campus, who are worried about getting a cut in funding or being socially ostracized or endangering their education for what they believe. It's conservatives. It's American conservatives who cannot say what they believe on campus. What's been great about the UK and the US as countries that have had immigration over and over again, successive waves of immigration, both ethnic and of various other kinds, is that people have come to the UK, people have come to the US with values in common. They've come and they have become British or become Americans. They have come believing in democracy, capitalism, and freedom. There's one group, one religious culture that has failed to do that everywhere that it has arrived. British Muslims are now less integrated and less assimilated, not more, than their parents and their grandparents' generation. We're now sending as many people to ISIS as Belgium, which is like a jihadi hotspot, right? You don't have large numbers of working class Muslims in this country. You have terrorists and you have nice middle class people who could afford to fly here, right? You don't have 1.4 million migrants like Germany does. But when you start to, if your politicians go the same way as Trudeau in Canada, when you start to, you're gonna see some of this stuff happen. And, you know, in answer to your question, the best thing that people can do is be educated about the realistic risks of living in close proximity with people who want them dead. The only people who are surprised by the fact that Muslims don't like gays very much is journalists, politicians, and celebrities. Everybody else gets it. The only people who are surprised are the people who write your newspapers. Yeah, I find a lot of what is said about Sadiq Khan to be slightly over the top. He's had some questionable friends in the past, but what's remarkable about that is how similar the world painted by Islam versus the world painted by feminism looks. They want all the same things. They want women covered up. They want the same people disintermediated. They want the same people shut up. They want the same people, you know, not to have platforms. The world painted by Islamism and the world painted by feminism look very similar. And, you know, the Soviets used to call left-wingers in America useful idiots. Well, for ISIS and for Saudi Arabia and for the, you know, the Wahhabist Muslims, for the Muslims who really are dedicated to the destruction of Western civilization, the most useful people in America are Gawker, BuzzFeed, Vox, Mike, the New York Times. All of these publications who routinely make excuses for unacceptable points of view or simply don't report on them at all. Donald Trump has never said anything to suggest that he is not fully in favor and support gays. In fact, his comments about trans bathroom stuff suggest that he is way more progressive than any Republican who has run for president possibly in 100 years. What his business decisions and his track record suggest is that he's probably the most gay-friendly candidate for president on either side for decades. Obama's done nothing for gays, Obama's done nothing for blacks. But Trump has made, in the comments that he has made, Trump has indicated to me that he might be the most gay-friendly president ever. And certainly, gay people are starting to pick up on this. Gay people are getting the message. Gay people are picking up on this, which is why now you've got the Gays for Trump movement, and people are starting to report all over the place that homosexuals are saying, you know what, despite myself, despite everything I thought and all the things I've been told and what the left has been telling me my whole life, I think I'm gonna go for that Trump guy. That's happening en masse in gay communities right now. And that's good, because Trump is gonna support the gun rights, they're gonna protect them. And everything that we know from Trump's biography and his history and his past suggests that he, as I say, could be the most gay-friendly president in history. I think Trump has done more to change the Republican Party and to change what Republicans are like than anybody else on that side of the aisle in 100 years. There's no reason to suppose he wouldn't do it on social issues too. What a lot of Republicans don't understand, but Trump instinctively clearly does, is that for many voters, not all of them, social conservatism is dead. These voters, you know, are pro-gay marriage. They don't care about, you know, they think the war, they rightly believe that the war on drugs has been a disgusting, expensive mess that has ruined lives. And Trump, I think, you know, I don't know what he thinks about drugs yet, but Trump certainly has indicated that he instinctively understands this new generation of Republican voters who don't care too much about the social conservatism of the old order. So, yeah, I mean, if you are thinking, I want somebody strong who's going to look after, you know, the direction of this country and look after me and not be wedded to the things that I don't like about Republicans from the 50s and 60s that the left has been telling me for 40 years, Trump could be your candidate.